Do you need to clean up noise or grain from your videos without investing in a third-party plugin? Then stick right here. So we are inside After Effects, and before I'll start, I just want to explain the difference between noise and grain. In one line, noise is to digital what grain is to film. And just like grain does to film, noise brings a gritty look and feel to an image or video. Now, depending on your artistic needs, sometimes you want to add noise or grain to your video, but on different occasions you want to remove or reduce it so it will match with the other shots or just because it is too distracting. In this case, I have this sugar eclair shot taken from a commercial for a bakery named Roladin. Stick until the end to see the entire commercial and also get some details about my full breakdown course about it. But for now, let's explore our options, assuming we want to reduce the noise in this clip, which is a result of shooting with a high-speed camera and a high ISO settings. So first I'm going to click on the Effects and Presets panel to open it, and I already typed in the word noise, which is isolating all the effects with the word noise in their title. I also selected few of them and applied them to this clip. Now, one of them is a built-in option, the VR denoise effect. If I'll enable it with its default settings and just preview the result, you can get a sense of what it does to the shot. It tries to remove most of the noise, but also leaves us with this very weird vignette at the edges, and I don't think it does a particularly good job. So I'll switch it off, and then I'll turn on the denoiser 3 effect, which is part of the Red Giant Magic Bullet effects, which means this is the third party effect. Now I'll open it up and I'll show you that I set the reduced noise to 100, which is the maximum. Again, I'll go to the beginning and I'll preview it, and hopefully you can see through the YouTube compression that it doesn't really do justice for this clip, meaning that we are still seeing a lot of apparent noise here. So we have another option, and this is my favorite to-go effect, which is the Reduce Noise plugin from Neat Video. I'm going to open it up and I'll enable it. Now, this is not a tutorial about this plugin, so I'm not going to cover it over here, but just to show you what it does, I'll click on the prepare word here, which is going to open up this custom interface, and you can auto profile this clip and then finesse with the settings. So I already did it, and this is the result, and this is actually looking very nice. However, this is going to cost you some money. Now, it's worth mentioning that there are more tools out there, such as the paid version of DaVinci Resolve, that can help you with this as well. But again, these are all premium tools, which are going to cost you extra dollars. So let me show you another way to work, which is a bit cumbersome when it comes to the workflow. However, it won't cost you anything, assuming you have a copy of Photoshop installed. I also think it produced impressive results compared to the other alternatives that we saw. So I'll switch off the effect over here, I'll go to the beginning, and I'm also going to switch to Photoshop, which is running in the background on my machine. Now I'm going to go to the File menu, and I'll choose Open as Smart Object, because I want to open the same video that I showed you, which is this guy. And since I'm opening it as a smart object, I can go to the Window menu and then choose the Timeline panel and then click on Create Video Timeline. And this will allow me to use any of the filters as smart filters and apply the results to the entire clip. So the one that I'm after is this guy, Camera Raw Filter. I'll select it. It's going to open up on top of Photoshop. And I'll go to the detail options. And over here, we have two sliders for noise reduction. I'll take the first one all the way to its maximum settings of 100. And to get rid of the color noise, first, let's just zoom in by clicking on the command here on the Mac, control on Windows, and just mark here around this area so you can see this color noise. I'm just going to take this all the way to its maximum value. and then let's zoom out. I'll click and hold on the visibility icon on the eye for the detail to show you the before and after. I'll click OK now. And we need to render it as a video file so we can use it back inside After Effects or any other software that you like. And to do it, I'll go to this option menu here in the timeline panel and choose Render Video. Now, depending on your needs, you can choose between different formats. So if you want, you can use the H.264 and render a high quality MP4 file. But I will recommend to choose the QuickTime option and then maybe go with uncompressed to create a high quality uncompressed file. I'm going to render it to my desktop here and click on render. I'm going to speed up this process, but I will tell you that on my machine, this took almost 1 minute to render. And once the render has finished, I'll bring back After Effects to the top, and then I'll double click on a gray portion in the project panel to import the file that I've just created, and I'm just going to place it above this clip. I'll stretch the boundary between the timeline and the composition viewer so we can see the before and after. We don't need any audio here. Actually, there isn't any audio for this clip, so I'll switch the speaker off, and I'm just going to show you this is the before version and this is the after one. I'll press spacebar to play it for you. And as you can see, this preserved all the details and the noise is completely gone. I hope that someday Adobe is going to port this technology directly into After Effects and maybe also Premiere Pro. But until they'll do it, I want to show you the full commercial so you'll get the context for this shot. So I'll double click on this composition and I'm also going to maximize it and then preview it for you. This commercial was made by OG Group Productions. The agency office for the client is Bruckner Yair Levy, and the post work was done by my friend Alon Tisson, and there's a link in the description for his portfolio, so go ahead and check him out. Now, if you like to get a glimpse behind the scenes of this commercial made entirely with After Effects and learn advanced techniques for compositing text and video together, click on the link in the description, which will take you to my full course over at LinkedIn Learning. If you don't have a membership, you can sign for 1 month free and then decide if you fancy to continue. But in any way, I want to thank you for watching this tutorial. Hopefully, you can now use Camera Raw to reduce or maybe even remove noise completely from your videos.